Dear students, my name is Dr. Manish A. Vyas, HOD Humanities and Science Department, VPMP Polytechnic, Gandhinagar. We are going to discuss today past tense and particularly simple past tense and how we can form sentences using past tense, affirmative, negative, and interrogative. The objectives of today's lecture is to make you familiar with formation of verbs in past tense, use of certain words and phrases associated with the past tense, and then there will be a class activity, which of course is not going to be a part of this lecture, but in our video lectures, I have asked you to complete certain assignments related to past tense. Now, when do we use past tense? We use past tense to show an event or an action which started and it got finished, it got completed at a specific time in the past. So, in order to show the specific time in the past, we have to use some time expressions or timing words without which past tense cannot be formed grammatically correct. See here. Now, which are these time expressions? The time expressions are last month, last week, last Sunday, last year. Yesterday is a very common word which we use in simple past tense sentences. In 1996, ago, these are some timing words or time expressions which we use or we have to use when we want to make sentences with past tense. Look at the examples. I met my grandparents last Sunday. If you say, I met my grandparents, full stop, then it is not a grammatically correct past tense. Whenever we use past tense, we have to use these timing words either in the beginning or at the end of the sentences. So, I met my grandparents last Sunday. Amar completed his post graduation in 2001. Sarika bought a new car last year. We saw a rainbow few moments ago. So, in these four sentences, last Sunday, in 2001, last year, ago, these are timing words or time expressions. Now, there are two types of verbs which are used generally in past tense, with which many of you are familiar. These two verbs are either regular verbs or irregular verbs. Now, what are regular verbs in the past tense? Regular verbs are those verbs that end with ed. Irregular verbs are those verbs that don't end with ed because their forms get changed. Present form is different, past form is different, and past participle form is different. They are known as irregular verbs. Here is an example of regular verbs and irregular verbs. Let us start from the left hand side. Simple form and regular verb. We also call simple form as present tense verb. Okay. So, for example, walk. So, past tense will be walked. Second is talk. The past tense is talked. Third is connect. Connected. Fourth is announce, announced. wife is rich. Past tense is reached. Last is robe. The past tense is robed. As you can see in these examples, all the verbs, they end with ed in the past tense. We are talking about past tense only. So these are known as irregular verbs of past tense. Now look at the other side. Simple form, and now the category is irregular verb. Become. So now here we cannot use ed. So the past tense will be became. Run. The past tense is ran. Sing. The past tense is sang. Hit. The past tense is hit. So here present tense and past tense, in both the tenses the verb spelling remain same and the pronunciation also remain same. Likewise, similarly, set. The past tense is also set. And then give, simple form, in present tense it is give, past tense is gave. So now in this category of irregular verbs, you can see that all the forms of the spellings get changed and ed is not used. So these are known as irregular verbs. So there are two categories, regular verb and irregular verb in the past tense. Now negative sentence pattern. How can we make negative of past tense? It's very simple. Did plus not, because it is negative sentence, and then simple form of the verb or main verb or present tense form of the verb. Look at the first example. Dharmesh completed his MBBS last year. Two things here are used which show it is past tense. One is the verb is in ed, completed, and the second word, which, what is the clue? Last year. So last year is a timing word. Negative. Dharmesh did not. Now we have to change completed into main verb, simple form. So the simple form is complete. Dharmesh did not complete his MBBS last year. Second example, my father took a leave from his work yesterday. Look at the verb, took, irregular verb. Why? ED is not used. And what is the timing word? Yesterday. Now let's make it negative. My father did not. Now what is the simple form, present form of took? It is take. Did not take leave from his work yesterday. So this way, negative sentence formation of past tense is very easy. Similarly, if you want to make a question sentence, we also call it interrogative sentence pattern, then what we have to do? We have to use did in the beginning of the sentence to make question. Then comes subject, and then main verb will be used. Look at the first example. Neha submitted the project last Monday. Now we have to make it interrogative. So we should start with did. Did Neha, now main verb or simple form of submitted is submit the project last Monday, and then question mark. Don't forget to put question mark in interrogative sentence. Mansi gave a lecture on environment. We have to make it interrogative. So we should start with did. Did Mansi, now simple form of the verb gave is give, a lecture on environment, question mark. In case you want to make negative of both the sentences, then what should be the answer? First sentence, Neha did not submit the project last Monday. Second sentence, Mansi did not give a lecture on environment. Okay, so simple past tense is very easy. You just have to take care of the verb and the timing. Words also. In negative and interrogative, both types of cases, we use did. So that's very easy. Thank you very much.